Time to get the Packer perspective here in 2022, catching up with Coach Calhoun. So what's it been like this summer getting ready, knowing expectations are always what they are here in Moultrie?
Expectations are high, but, you know, I don't want to be at a place that doesn't have high expectations. It really makes you be prepared, you know, be prepared daily, weekly, monthly. And our kids have been working hard, and coaches have been working hard, because obviously our schedule is not an easy one. You know, each day we do it, we get a little bit closer to the season.
Let's talk about the R words, reclassification and region. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the reactions we get, because a lot of times when you talk about reclassification, you think you've got everything squared away, and then it gets thrown back in the blender, and then it comes back out the other side, and you got to get everything squared away again. Now that reclassification is settled, you know what you're up to the next 2 years. Let's talk reclassification and region, and what do you see?
The region definitely didn't get any easier. 7A did not get any easier, but, you know, I mean, you know you're going to play really good teams, and teams are going to have really good players and really good coaches, and it doesn't matter who's on the schedule, you know, or who's in 7A. There's going to be a bunch of teams that you got to go through, you know, to kind of win your region and then win the championship. So, again, it kind of goes back to your first question. With the level of competition, we know that we got to be prepared every Friday night.
One of the more interesting things that is about this particular region is a coaching tree that is a part of what's going on. And there's a rivalry that's down the road. Let me see if I can get my geography correct. As we're doing this, it'll be that way. It'll be over Wes Nichols' left shoulder, heading that way, about 40 minutes. And you now have Zach Grage, who's at Lowndes, you being here, the Rush Probst coaching tree in one region with two of the heavyweights here in South Georgia.
And also Coach Felton at Valdosta.
Right, that's true.
So, you know, I mean, it just adds to those weeks. You know, I mean, as if anything, you know, needed to be added to, you know, to those Fridays. But the three of us are friends, you know, and we wish each other the best of luck, all except probably, you know, when we go against each other. So, but again, I know they're really good at what they do. So, you know, so those weeks we got to be prepared.
Let me ask you this. Being a part of that coaching tree, what was the first lesson that you learned from Rush that stuck?
You know, that's a tough question. For me, just kind of a yearly overall structure. You know, obviously, you know, when I want to come work for him, it was to be a head coach. You know, so just the ins and outs, and, you know, and the daily schedule of a head coach. You know, sometimes football kind of falls a little bit behind, but I know what I signed up for.
All right, last question for you, and thanks for letting us come and crash here at the Fieldhouse.
Thank you for coming.
One of the elements here that's right here between us, doing it for Chase, the 42, you see the towels up all over the place. For those that don't know the story, a little background on that.
So when I was at Carrollton, I got there in 2016, and I had a young man who was a ninth grader, and so obviously he went through the program, and 2019 was a tough year for, you know, for all of us. Chase was diagnosed with cancer, passed away in November, actually passed away the day after our first round playoff game, November 16th. And so you can see that, that's Chase running through the banner, and actually got his locker nameplate there. I love their family. And so he's always with me. And so that's kind of a daily reminder.
Because, you know, these kinds of daily reminders, what they're there for, it centers us, I think, and it brings us back and reminds us what's important, and all what high school athletics and high school football specifically that we're here talking about it can do. It can bring these families together, and you learn lessons, unfortunately, sooner than you have to sometimes. But you have these kinds of memories and these kinds of reminders about what really is important.
Absolutely, and it also brings communities together. You know, Chase just taught me, and he's teaching a lot of people still, that football is great, you know, but the most important day is today. And, you know, and he believed in the Lord. And so, you know, so it was just just honored to be a part of his life, you know, and to see his legacy continue.
That's the early story down here in Moultrie, Colquitt County in 2022.